Okay, so welcome everyone to Carol's Corner. I'm your host, Carol Bremner, and we're here every Thursday for 30 minutes while we learn how to go from knowledge to profit by sharing our expertise online. And I like to have a guest as often as I can. And today's session is Smart Podcasting, and I have a very special guest. And it's podcasting pioneer, Kelly McCausey. And Kelly, I hope you don't mind that I used that phrase, but because when I saw it, I thought that was really interesting that you were podcasting even before the days that it was called podcasting, right?
Yeah. Sort of.
So I'll just tell you a little bit about Kelly McCausey in case you're not sure who she is. Kelly has been making money online, doing the things that she loves since 2002, and she's blogging and podcasting over at solosmarts.com, where she's proving that solopreneurs are smarter. And I know we have a number of solopreneurs here with us on the webinar today. And I noticed that one of the things it said on your website was that in 2012, from your Solo Smarts podcast, over 170,000 MP3s were downloaded. That's very impressive, Kelly.
Oh, thank you. I need to update that, huh?
Oh, so that was from before? It's way more than that?
I don't know. I need to check.
Because that says 2012. So, yes, yeah. It's liable to be way more than that. So, yeah, that would be really interesting. Okay, so for anyone who isn't familiar with podcasting, can you first of all just explain to us what is a podcast?
Sure. The technical definition of a podcast is any media file being delivered by RSS. So a podcast can be an audio, a video, it can be a PDF, it can be an item of software, any media file delivered to the end user by RSS. It's podcasting.
I always thought a podcast was just audio.
That's what a lot of people think of, because podcasting, that was what was easiest to do when podcasting was invented or discovered, was audio. But, yep, videos can be podcasted as well.
Wow. So I might be a podcaster without even knowing it.
Yeah. If you're delivering your content by RSS.
Okay, so that's the defining term.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Can you explain what an RSS is for anybody who's not familiar with that?
Sure. RSS stands for Really Simple Syndication. Mm-hmm. And if you're using a WordPress site or Blogger, you know, any blogging or content management software of any kind, it creates an RSS feed. Your post content is distributed by the RSS feed. So since most of us are familiar with WordPress, if you have a WordPress site, items that you post as a post get posted to the RSS feed. And anybody with an RSS reader can subscribe to your feed and read whatever content you decide to share by RSS.
So if you had a YouTube channel, would that be an RSS feed too, or not necessarily?
I believe that YouTube gives you a way to provide an RSS feed.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
I haven't looked at that recently.
Okay.
But I believe it's a function.
Okay.
Interestingly enough, though, with your WordPress sites, if you post content to a page, mm-hmm. not a post, that is not sent out through your feed.
Oh.
Just so you know.
Yes, that's very good to know. Okay, so First of all, can you talk a little bit about what the benefits are of having a podcast?
Oh, yes. Well,
and most of my questions are probably more an audio podcast, since that's what I thought it was when I did this.
Sure. Podcasting is content marketing, pure and simple. We need to be content marketing. We need to be expressing our ideas, our message, our answers to problems, solutions to issues, inspiring stories. We need to be sharing, you know, our message with the world. That's what content marketing is all about. It's getting your message out in front of its intended market.
Mm-hmm.
And if you write all day long and fill the internet with text content, you're doing a wonderful thing, but you're going to miss a lot of people who don't read on the internet.
Mm-hmm.
There are lots of people who have never read a blog and never will because they just don't love reading.
Mm-hmm.
But they love listening, and they listen to things all the time. So if you provide them with an audio version of your content, you're going to reach more of your intended market. And there's something really exciting about this. When I started my internet radio show in 2003,
mm-hmm.
and when podcasting came out in 2004, it was exciting for me to reach my audience, but I had to reach them very intentionally. I had to go out and say, hey, did you know there's such a thing as internet radio? Come listen to my show. And then I said, had to say, do you know there's such a thing as podcasting? Come listen to my podcast.
Mm-hmm.
I had to teach my market about what I had available to them. These days, it's much more commonly understood.
Mm-hmm.
Folks know what a podcast is. Most people do.
Mm-hmm.
And most people know how easy it is to get a hold of a podcast. Most people are familiar with iTunes, and a growing number of people are familiar with things like Stitcher.
Mm-hmm.
The media in general is starting to blend. So pretty soon you'll be able to listen to my podcast in your car, not because you downloaded it from iTunes, but because you just tuned into it in some way through the radio. Someday that's going to happen, and it's going to happen pretty darn quick. So it's easier than ever to reach those audio learners, and you need to be. You need to be communicating to them in the way that they want to listen.
Okay, that's good. So would a podcast be suitable for any occupation? For instance, I have a friend who's a chiropractor, and she's been wondering if she should start a podcast.
I think so. Years ago, we're talking back in 2005, I think, I wrote an article, You'll Be Podcasting Sooner or Later. And I really believe it. We traditionally think of a podcast as a weekly show. Like my podcast is Solo Smarts, is a weekly show.
Okay.
I've been publishing a weekly show forever. Sometimes I miss a week, but my intention is to be weekly. Well, you know, there's no rules with podcasting. You don't have to publish weekly. You can publish biweekly.
Mm-hmm.
You can publish monthly, though I don't really recommend it. People forget about you.
Mm-hmm.
But you can even throw out the whole idea of weekly or biweekly, and you can do podcasts, say 10 episodes, and call it a season, like season one of my podcast. There's 10 episodes.
Mm-hmm.
And then you can take a break and come back the next fall and record 10 more episodes.
Mm-hmm.
That's what the cable TV shows do, you know?
Mm-hmm.
There are no rules. So your chiropractor friend could absolutely plan out 10 topics, perhaps 10 common questions people have if they've never been to a chiropractor. And he or she could sit down and record the question and the answer, a 10-15 minute podcast. and publish those 10 podcasts over the course of 10 weeks, and then they're just available. You know, iTunes is a search engine, so if somebody has received an iPhone for Christmas or their birthday or Mother's Day or whatever, mm-hmm. and they're opening up iTunes for the first time, they're going to discover that there's podcasts on all kinds of content.
Mm-hmm.
And they might decide to search for information on back pain or nerve, pinched nerves, or any number of things. They may be looking for a book in iTunes,
mm-hmm.
because a lot of people do that. And they're going to find your podcast too, because iTunes is going to serve them up all kinds of media, books on tape, podcasts, you name it. So your chiropractor's content is going to pop up for people, and they're going to have a chance to listen and know, like, and trust her.
Mm-hmm.
And Carol, content marketing is what won me over to a chiropractor years ago.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah, it wasn't a podcast, of course. It was actually a flyer in a newspaper. But it could just as easily have been a blog post or a podcast.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
They told a story about a man who was living with absolutely debilitating pain.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't say that word right. It's one of those words I can.
I know what you mean.
But he had horrible, horrible pain, and the chiropractor, over a period of several months of treatment, restored his strength and his motion, and his life was changed. And reading that story, I cried like a baby, because I had been living with horrendous lower back pain for years.
Mm-hmm.
And it gave me the courage to go to the chiropractor. Mm-hmm. So yeah, chiropractors, everybody, if you have solutions to problems, if you have stories that inspire, you should be podcasting.
Okay, I'll make sure I let her know that. And before we go any further, I forgot to mention that if anyone has any questions as we're going along, just type them in the question box, and I'm keeping an eye on it. And as soon as I'm able to, I'll ask Kelly what the answers are. So go ahead if you have questions while we're going along. So you mentioned, Kelly, that 15 minutes even. So is that a good...
Yeah.
Length of time?
It just depends on your subject matter. For some people, 15 minutes would not be enough time. But for some, it would be just right. For some, it might be a little bit much. I've listened, Paul Evans, when he podcasts, it could be anywhere from 6 minutes to 15 minutes. He's got a topic to share. He talks until he's done talking.
Mm-hmm.
And if 6 months was 6 minutes was just right, then it's just right.
Okay.
As a podcast listener, I enjoy length that suits the topic. So I think if it's about, you know, like sharing chiropractor answers, 10-15 minutes is just right.
Okay.
If it's you know, if it were to be more of, like, say, a holistic health show,
mm-hmm.
you probably need more like 30 minutes, 45 minutes to really treat the topics right.
Okay.
You know? So, just depends on what you're doing.
Okay, good. So, I know kind of what you're going to answer a little bit, but other people may not. I have used Blog Talk Radio in the past about 3 times, and the reason is because it was so easy. So what are your thoughts about using Blog Talk Radio for podcast?
Well, if you use Blog Talk Radio, you have a choice between using their free service or
which is paying. What I used. Okay, I used the free one. Mm-hmm.
If you use the free service, then when One of the things people like about Blog Talk Radio is that you can host a live call-in show and have a live chat operating. So, you know, you can do live internet radio and then the recording is podcasted. But the problem is the page that people are listening to your show on is filled with advertising.
Okay.
It's very distracting. If you are using Blog Talk Radio to create your show because you love the live call-in, I would much prefer that you go ahead and pay a premium cost to be able to, you know, drop the advertising.
Mm-hmm.
But in order to have no banner ads, you have to be paying them $250 a month.
Oh, really?
There's another level of 99, and then there's a lower level of 39, but when you pay the 39 or the 99, they're still displaying their ads.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm just not wild about that.
Mm-hmm.
But if you are going to use Blog Talk Radio because you love the features, whatever, if you ignore my argument about their distractions, still have your own site. Still post your show notes to your site, your own domain on your own hosting that you control, and make that the site that you send everyone to
okay.
listen later. I don't like people hosting on Blog Talk Radio and sending everyone to Blog Talk Radio.
Okay.
You know, I understand I have to go to Walmart to buy Kraft macaroni and cheese. You know, I get
mm-hmm.
that. But that's not appropriate for a podcast. Don't send me to Blog Talk Radio to consume your
uh-huh.
content.
Okay.
Send me to your house.
Okay. I think the reason I liked it was because you could just, and it was a while ago, but I think I could just use my telephone, so then I didn't have to worry about any technology whatsoever.
Yeah. Yeah. That's
okay.
True.
All right. So since we're talking about technology, is podcasting the proper way, not using Blog Talk Radio, but is it difficult and do you have to be technical, or is there an easier way?
I don't think it's difficult, but it is technical.
Okay.
Getting started. The good news is, if you have figured out how to blog,
mm-hmm.
podcasting is only like two or three technical steps beyond that, as far as learning how to record your audio, make edits, and post it, you know, to your site. Most of the technical bits are done up front in starting the podcast, and then it's pretty, you know, it's really is, there isn't a lot of new technology to conquer along the way.
Okay. Okay.
If you are overwhelmed by technology, you can have somebody help you set it up. You can hire someone to do, you know, all the technical bits for you.
And
you
who
can
would
even
you
outsource?
Okay. I was going to say, what would you look for if you were looking for someone to help you with it? Do they have a special name or something like that?
Well, as far as launching?
I don't know. Any technical things?
You're looking for a multimedia VA.
Okay.
Now, I teach a podcasting course. And I offer a done-for-you podcast consulting package for someone who wants it done right, wants it done without any worries, and they want, you know, my expertise. They can hire me to do that.
Okay.
But alternatively, you're looking for a VA who has multimedia experience.
Okay.
And be careful, though, because some people will say, yeah, I can help you do that. But make sure you check and get some testimonials.
Okay.
Some proof that they've done it before.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Now, if someone was going to go ahead and try starting themselves, what are the basics that you need to start?
You need a USB headset with a mic on it.
Okay.
About $30 is what you'll spend on that. That's what I'm using right now to talk to you here in the GoToWebinar.
Okay.
It's the same thing I use to record my podcasts. You need recording software like Audacity, which is totally free and very acceptable. And you're going to use your WordPress site. You're going to use a plugin like PodPress. You're going to choose some sort of technology for recording conversations if you're going to do interviews or have a co-host. For me, I use Skype and a piece of software called Pamela.
Okay.
Skype, if you're just Skyping with people, of course it's free.
Mm-hmm.
Pamela, I paid $20 for a professional license with Pamela. And that's how I record my Skype calls. I actually go a step further with Skype, and I subscribe to their online number, which lets people call me just as if they were calling a telephone.
Oh.
I use that for my business line.
Mm-hmm.
And I use Skype Out, which is unlimited U.S. and Canada calling for $2 a month.
Okay.
So
now I've got a question for a sec, Kelly.
Sure.
Susan is asking, is that Pamela like the woman's name?
Yes. Pamela.biz is where you find that software.
Okay.
That's what I use. I've used that for a really long time. You can also Google a free Skype recorder. And there is other software that you can use that you don't have to pay for. That's come out since Pamela, and I've never tried it. I've just always used Pamela. And for $20, it's pretty darn affordable.
Mm-hmm.
It's a one-time fee.
Yeah.
So my Skype Out lets me call out to guests, and my online number lets them call into me. And whether it's a Skype call or a phone call, it's just right through Skype, so Pamela can record either way. So headset, recording software, a plugin for your blog, and a way to record a phone call. If you're not going to use Skype or Skype Out or online number, you are probably going to use like freeconferencecall.com to record yourself, or maybe Audio Acrobat.
Mm-hmm. So you mentioned, go ahead, sorry Kelly.
I'm going to say those are the simple technical pieces that you need.
Okay. Now you mentioned WordPress as well. Is that because the podcast is going to be coming directly from your WordPress blog?
Yes. You're going to record your podcast, whether it's just your voice or an interview. You're going to edit and make it sound just the way you want it to go out to your audience. You're going to upload that audio file to your chosen hosting, whether it's your own server or Amazon hosting, whatever.
Mm-hmm.
And then you're going to come back to WordPress and you're going to create a post. And you're going to write some show notes that tell people about what you're talking about in your podcast.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to use the plugin to add the MP3 link to that post. And you're going to publish it to your podcasting category.
Okay.
And bam, you just podcasted.
Now
you're going to take the, when you publish your very first show, once you've published an MP3 to your podcast category, you're going to create a feed from that category and take it over and submit it to iTunes. And that's how you get it, so that people can subscribe to you in iTunes.
Okay.
There's a lot of steps, and I'm making it sound very simple.
Yeah, I think you make it sound easier than it is.
I know it's not as simple as it sounds when you're tackling each of these unfamiliar things one after another, but that's why I created a course mm-hmm. about it with checklists and timetable, you know, real clear, this is what you do.
Yes, yes.
Sort of information.
So, and we're going to be showing that course in just a sec, but are there any other tips, first of all, that you'd like to share with us, or?
Podcasting is fun. You know, once you get over the technical, the early steps that are truthfully a little overwhelming, once you get rolling, it's rinse and repeat. There's a delightful payoff in it. Most people fall in love with it. The important thing to remember is that there just are no rules.
Okay.
Make the podcast what you would enjoy, and don't feel bad. If you start down one direction, say having a weekly podcast like mine, and realize you're not having fun, feel free to change it up and change format and pursue something different.
Mm-hmm.
But don't give up, because it really does have long-term value.
Okay. And I know from listening to different ones of yours before, sometimes you will have, I guess, just you or maybe one person, and then you've had other times when you've had a group of people, which has been a lot of fun.
Yeah. There's so many different ways to podcast.
Mm-hmm.
And the variety is what appeals to me.
Okay, so Kelly, as she mentioned, has a podcasting course, and maybe you can just tell us a little bit more about it, and then
sure.
I'll just repeat this link.
Well, when I started my internet radio show in 2003, I started it on November 3rd, and by Christmas time, I'd had at least a dozen people say, could you please help me start one?
Mm-hmm.
So I've been teaching people how to do this for almost... Well, it is. It's over 10 years now. It was my 10th anniversary this last November.
Wow.
I have a course, Smart Blogging Skills. It's a 6-week course. There are 6 audios with text notes and to-do list and a bunch of little tutorials of specific technical bits showing you how to do this, showing you how to do that. You get the whole thing. So while I call it a 6-week course, it's probably more appropriate to say a 6-part course, because some people just blast through it and launch their podcast in 10 days. How fast you do it is entirely up to you.
Okay.
The course is $69, but I have given Carol a coupon code to save you $20.
Yes, yes, and I was going to mention that. So you can go to smartpodcasting.carolbremner.com, and that's where you can use the coupon. So if you put in Carol20 as a coupon code, then you'll save $20, like Kelly said. And I'm a member of her mastermind group, and after all of this, I can hardly wait to dig into this, because it's part of that group as well. So if there are no questions, and I don't see anything here, and we're almost out of time, but Kelly, thank you so much for being my guest today. I really, really appreciate it. Susan is asking something. If you can post it here, we can copy and paste. I've got it on a slide, Susan, so unless you can just get it off the slide, it's just the smartpodcasting.carolbremner.com. Sorry, I'm not very techie when it comes to these slides either. So, but I think you probably could maybe just highlight it and try to copy it. I can't say for sure. Do you know, Kelly?
I am not able to highlight and copy it from my end.
Okay.
It doesn't let me do that.
Okay. All right. So I'm sorry, you're going to have to just type it in. So smartpodcasting.carolbrunner.com.
Will you be emailing out the replay or?
Yes. I'll be emailing out the real. Yes, later today I'll be emailing that, and I can make it as a clickable link in the email as well. So if you want to wait until that, that's fine. So Kelly, thank you so much for having us here. Yes, Susan's just saying you cannot highlight from the slide. I know, an admin person, Susan's saying an admin person usually does the typing here for us all to see. So I'm here on my own, Susan. I don't have an admin person with me, but actually maybe I could type it in. Okay. I know what she's saying here, I think. No, it's not going to let me do it. Sorry, Susan. I know I was thinking I could just type it in the chat, but it doesn't look like it wants to let me type anything in there. So sorry about that. So as I was saying, Kelly, thank you so much for being here with me. I really appreciate it. I know you're very busy, and I appreciate you taking the time, and I encourage everyone to at least check out this podcasting course of Kelly's, because she really does go through a lot of different things. So, and our for next week, I'm going to be having Teresa Miller, who is also in Kelly's mastermind group with me here, and we're going to talk about Kindle. So we're just getting some thank yous, Kelly, for all of your information. It's been very appreciated. So thank you again, Kelly, and thanks all of you for being here. So have a great day, and until next week, we'll see you then. Have fun. Bye-bye.